12th Biobotany, Chapter 6, Principles of Ecology. In this part, we are going to learn about edaphic factors and topographic factors. Edaphic factors are soil factors. Soil is formed from rocks. The study of soil is called pedology. Soil formation is initiated by the process weathering of rocks. It is nothing but breaking of rocks into pieces. Weathering of rocks initiates the soil formation. Biological weathering is due to bacteria, fungi, lichens, and plants. These organisms produce chemicals and acid. These acid and chemicals lead to weathering of rocks. Let us see the important edaphic factors which affect vegetation. Soil moisture, soil water, soil reactions, soil nutrients, soil temperature, soil atmosphere, soil organisms. These are the important edaphic factors which affect vegetation. Soil water is the most important factor that determines the distribution of plants. The soil water influences the distribution of plants in different areas. What is the source of water? Rain is the source of all water. The rain water flows on Earth's surface. Due to the gravity, the water moves inside and stays between soil particles. Some amount of water is absorbed on the surface of soil particles. This is combined water or adsorbed water. This water is not available for the plants because there is force between the water and soil particles. So this water cannot be separated by the roots. In between the soil particles, there is microcapillary space. This microcapillary space is filled with water, that is capillary water. This water is available for the plants that can be absorbed by the root system. There are three kinds of soil reactions: acidic or alkaline or neutral. pH is a measure of acidity and alkalinity. The pH value of the soil solution determines the availability of plant nutrients. Plant nutrients in the soil is determined by the pH value. 5.5 to 6.8 is suitable for plant growth. Soil provides all the nutrients needed for the plants. Plants need nutrients for their growth. The essential plant nutrients are provided by the soil. Soil has minerals and organic nutrients in the form of ions. Soil temperature decides or determines the distribution of different vegetations on Earth's surface. It determines the geographical distribution of plants. When the temperature is low, plants reduce the water use. When the temperature is low, when the soil temperature is low, the plants use less water, plants absorb less water, plants absorb less solutes. Soil atmosphere is nothing but soil air. The roots need oxygen for respiration, that is taken from soil atmosphere. In between the soil particles, the space has oxygen and carbon dioxide. Soil organisms play an important role in maintaining soil fertility. Bacteria, fungi, algae, protozoans, nematodes, insects, and earthworms are various soil organisms. Bacteria and fungi are decomposers. Blue-green algae add nitrogen to the soil. Earthworms are friend of farmers. The earthworms add humus to the soil, and earthworms loosen the soil. The movement of the earthworms loosen the soil. So bacteria, fungi, earthworms involve in improving the soil fertility. The soils are classified based on the size of soil particles and the composition. Clay soil, the particle size is less than 0.002 millimeter. It has 50% clay and 50% silt. Silt is a decomposing matter. This soil is poorly aerated. This soil cannot support the growth of plants. It cannot facilitate the growth of plants. Here there will be water logging. Water stagnation will take place, and the soil is poorly aerated. Silt soil, the soil particle size ranges between 0.002 to 0.02 millimeter. 90% silt and 10% sand. Loamy soil, the particle size ranges between 0.002 to 2 millimeter. It is composed of 70% sand and 30% clay or silt. This soil holds water. It has good water holding capacity, and there will be no water logging or water stagnation, and it has good amount of decomposing matter also. Sandy soil, the soil size 0.2 to 2 millimeter, large size particles, 80% sand and 50% clay. This soil cannot hold water. It has poor water holding capacity. Loamy soil is ideal for the growth of plants because it retains water and it has proper drainage of water. It does not allow water stagnation, and it provides adequate aeration because 70% it has sand. Topographic factors influence the surface features of the earth. Topography means the surface feature of earth. When we see the surface of the earth, some areas have a particular kind of vegetation, some areas have forest, some areas have grassland. This is because of interaction of solar radiation, temperature, humidity, rainfall, latitude and altitude. So these climatic factors influence the microclimate. Microclimate is the specific climate or climatic variation in a small area. The climatic variation in a small area is called as microclimate. That is influenced by these factors, and all these factors influence the topographic features on the earth. The important topographic factors are latitude, altitude, direction of mountain, steepness of mountain. Let us see the four factors one by one. Already we discussed about latitude, altitude in the previous video. This is equator. The distance from equator towards the polar region is latitude. Equator has high temperature. The temperature decreases towards the poles, North Pole and South Pole. The temperature is varying between the equator region and the polar region. Because of the varying temperature, there are variations in the vegetations in between these two regions. When we move upwards from the sea level, that is altitude, increase in the height from sea level is altitude. The high altitude has poor wind and low temperature, low air pressure but high humidity and high intensity of light. So these factors, wind, temperature, air pressure are high in the altitude, but lower regions, sorry, wind, temperature, air pressure is low in the altitudes. Wind, temperature, air pressure is high in the lower regions. Humidity, intensity of light is high in the altitudes. Because of these factors, there are different zones of vegetations. Different zonation of vegetations because of the variation in different climatic factors in different altitudes. Direction of mountain influences the growth of vegetation. North slope, south slope, both the slopes have variation in the humidity, rainfall, light intensity, light duration. These factors are varying in between the north slope and south slope. The microclimate of the two slopes are different. One of the slopes receives more rainfall. One of the slopes receives more sunlight. When we go to the northern hemisphere, the south slope receives more sunlight. And when we go to the southern hemisphere, the north slope receives more sunlight. So in between north slope and south slope, these factors are varying. So vegetations are varying between north slope and south slope. One of the slopes receive heavy rainfall and vegetations are very high. A mountain has two regions, windward region and leeward region. The windward region has more wind, it brings good rainfall. So this area is rich with vegetation. Leeward region is poorly vegetated because of poor rainfall. Steepness of the mountain also influences the distribution of vegetation. Mountain slopes allow runoff water. The slopes allow runoff water. So the water, running water, carries away the topsoil. Topsoil is carried away. So this area cannot support vegetation. So these areas are poorly vegetated. But the valley and plain areas support the growth of vegetation. In aquatic bodies like pond, lakes, the soil slope changes the water depth. At the center of the water bodies, the area is deeper, but edges are shallow. Rooted plants are on the edges, and the center has no rooted plant. The soil slope in aquatic bodies change the water depth, that changes the type of vegetation in different depth of water bodies. Ecotone is the area between two ecosystems. The transition zone between two ecosystems is ecotone. Here this is grassland ecosystem, this is mountain. In between the two, the border has different climate, different microclimate. This area has different kinds of vegetation. This is one ecosystem and another ecosystem. In between two ecosystems, different kinds of vegetations are there. This is because of the influence of two different climates. Two different climates of two different ecosystems influence the formation of different vegetation zone in between the ecosystem. This is called as edge effect. The climatic conditions between the edges of two ecosystems is different. In that area, the vegetations are different. This is called as edge effect.